There's an increasing number of smartphones which have opted for a micro SIM over the standard SIM card that you might be used to. The HTC One S here and the iPhone 4S are just two really obvious examples of that. This is a standard SIM card, and this is a micro SIM. Now, if you upgrade your handset without upgrading your contract, you might need to actually cut down your SIM card yourself, or alternatively, you can buy one from your carrier. But if you don't want to wait and you want to do it yourself, I'm going to show you how to cut it down with a few simple tools. All you need is a scalpel, a ruler, some sort of template, a micro SIM tray, and a surface with which to cut them. So to cut it, first what I'm going to do is overlay this SIM card, but you could obviously use your template, and position it so you can see both contacts from both SIM cards. What this is actually showing me is how much I can take off this side here. I'm going to take my scalpel, just make a mark on the corner. I'm going to do the same again for the vertical. Now I've marked those, I'll take my ruler and score all the way down the edge, making sure I have a straight line all the way down. Do the same on this side. And then I've marked out this bottom corner here. From this point, I can then use the measurements from these lines to work out the height and the width of the SIM. Micro SIM is 15 millimeters this way and 12 millimeters this way. We're exactly 15 there and exactly 12 there. So along the score, I've now put my ruler so I've got exactly the right amount of plastic exposed on this edge. And then I'm just going to keep scoring. You have to press very hard, so you have to be careful with your fingers. So once you've scored along the same line enough times and pressed quite hard, you should start to cut through the material. So you can see it's started to come away at this end here. The idea being that once it's thin enough, you can actually just bend it away. And it should just come away like that. Now it's just a process of repeating that same process. So now we've cut two edges, we can actually start measuring the SIM up correctly. So the width of the SIM should measure 12, and at the moment we've taken it down to just around 14. So if I just make sure it's exactly straight with the edge of the new edge that we've created, and then again make a mark. And because the SIM's quite long, I'll do a mark higher up so I can line my two marks up and make sure I have a straight edge. Okay. Line it up again along the new edge. And again, repeat that same scoring process until the plastic starts to give away. There's two more cuts to do. We need to cut the top to get the correct height. And of course, we need to take the corner out. So the height from our new bottom line is 15 millimeters. So again, I'm making sure I'm using the chip to make sure I have a straight edge with the ruler. Make a mark there. Now I'll do the same here. Line my two marks up. And again. Repeat that scoring process. Using this T-Mobile SIM card, it should sit just below the text printed on the SIM when you're cutting this top cut. So the last major section, the bit of coercion should come away as well. There we go. So right now we have a pretty rectangular SIM. So the last bit is the corner. So if you use your SIM or your template, rest over the top, you can see at the moment that the height and the width are pretty much spot on. If they're slightly larger or slightly off, it doesn't matter too much. There's a little bit of room for error in this process, which is nice. So I'm going to rest it back down and make sure these two SIM cards are as evenly spaced over each other as possible. Oops. So about there looks right. Apply some even pressure on the top. And then again, just gently score the corner. Once you've done enough scoring, because there's such a little amount of plastic that you actually have to cut through, with enough force, it should just snap off. You can see it comes away with a clean edge. It's actually the cleanest edge we've got. Compared to, it's looking pretty good. So you've got your cut sim. Push it in. And this particular phone has a click mechanism, so you know it's secured in there. And it's really just a case of putting the battery door back on and turning the phone on and seeing what happens. So as you can see, the phone's registered the SIM card and we've got some signal. So that's how to make a micro SIM.